you're going to use this . Is that hooking and mooning, Cornelius? Do you think so? Hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft, Viking Heritage. Yeah, today I'm with Cornelius out in the forest here, in Royal Forest, and as you can see, it's a beautiful weather. It's totally no wind, and the sun is shining at the moment. Yeah, and as you saw, In the beginning, I collected some leaves from stinging needles, and that's because I want to make a stinging needle soup today. That's the thing that the Vikings often used, because in stinging needles there's a lot of good stuff, vitamins and so on, so it's a healthy diet. Yeah, now I see if I can find a pole to my banner. I didn't bring my spear with me, so I have to find a pole and then some firewood so I can begin preparing my food out here. Yeah. I hope you'll enjoy this day together with Cornelius and me, and yeah.
Yeah, and I think this dead standing spruce will be a good piece of pole to my flag, my banner, and some firewood. That'll do. Thank you. Yeah.
And in my soup, I want some carrots. Yeah. And then this vegetable that is called pastinac. Don't know what it's called in English. Oops, I have to do it like this. If it's the same name on English, pastinac, it could be. This is also a vegetable that they had in the Viking Age. This will do, and some spring onions. Yep, with a little grass on, it's all green. Yep, and then an onion, and that's nothing for you, Cringers. You can't. Dogs can't eat onions. They are actually poison for dogs. For those of you who don't know that, at least raw onions. If I make a stew or something with onion in or a meal, it doesn't matter when it's cooked or fried, but raw onion is not good. Oops. And then, last but not least, some garlic. I think that is okay. So now I have to put the pot on and it is cracking. I don't like that sound, so I think I'll put some water in. As I said, I could hear some cracking. And I don't know if that's just normal or what. But nevertheless, I put the rest of the vegetable in like this. And hope for the best. And then we put the stinging needle leaves in. See, I could get them up here. Yep. And if you're going to use this, use the fine small leaves. That is fresh, then it will taste good. Add a little more water in. And this time I'll try this. It's Nordur salt, blueberry, sea salt. I hope this will taste good in a soup. A little bit sweetness. There you are. And I recently made a video about where I show these salts. You can see on this picture there's 6 different kinds of salt. And yeah, I'm going to try them out one at a time and see which one is best for what. So. Yeah. And together with the soup, I want some bread, some flatbread. So I'm going to make a little one, a small flatbread. Flour, honey for sweetener, oil, yep, and why not some blueberry salt, yeah. And then of course some water. Yeah, Cornelius, it's not for you. At least not now. More water. And, no. And the soup is boiling nicely. No, night. Then my hands are still wet. A little bit more flour in. Oh, what up. Yeah. Yes, this will do. I have to clean my fingers. Bit more water in. Here the water is, I think there's a crack in it, that's why it sounds like that. And that's a shame, because I would like to, could have used it for an alternative pot. Yeah. And I try to do it like this. not sure there's heat enough for the breads, but I think I can soon I can take off the pot. It's been boiling for a long time now.
Yeah.
I think I remove the pot. I can do that.
Yeah.
And let it rest here. And then put up the fire here over my flatbread. Yep. Producing a lot of heat now. Yeah. And then I can begin preparing my coffee. Now I think it's done, and I can put my water over for my coffee. And there's no rush. See here. And I used my new spoon. You see here, I burned this little thing in. My spork spoon. Yeah. just regular sea salt from Nordur. Yeah, and some of you maybe wonder why I haven't uploaded a video in 14 days, half a month, and that's because I'm very busy back home. I'm making a lot of stuff for my Viking tent. I'm making some furniture and other things that I can use when I'm out in the Viking tent. And it takes a lot of time, so I prioritize that. And then I made this video for you to enjoy this week, and hopefully next week I can find a place where I can come up and put my tent up and show you all the stuff I made. So I'm very excited for that. I think it's a good choice I'm making, and yeah, I hope you like that too.
And look what I found: polypore mushroom. Or fungus.
Yeah, and in a later video I'll show you what you can use this for. Yeah, folks, this is all for now. I hope you enjoyed this little video from a wonderful place here in northern part of Jutland. Yeah, you saw I made my stinging needle soup with other vegetables. Very tasty, I can say, and the blueberry salt tasted great in that soup. A little bit sweet, and yeah, I like that. So, yeah, then again, thank you for joining us, Cornelius and me, out here in this wonderful forest, and then I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye-bye. Take care.